What is up, guys? Welcome to my review for Supergirl Season 4, Episode 15, titled Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? This is probably the first episode, aside from the Elseworlds crossover, that I was actually excited for this season. The reason for that is because, one, the trailers looked really good, and second, Lex Luthor was debuting in this episode. He has appeared before, but only in a flashback as a kid. This is the first time we're actually seeing him in the present day and as an adult, and that's a pretty big deal because he's probably the most famous, if not the second most famous villain of all time. The only one that is really a contender is the Joker. So this is definitely a big deal, and I think they kind of nailed it. I think Lex Luthor was, John Cryer, the actor who played him, was great in the role. For the most part in this episode, he was sick, and that kind of was acting a little bit, but I think that when he wasn't sick, he was really, really good. Like, at the beginning in the flashback, 4 years ago, they showed, like, a flashback to when he went to jail. In the beginning of season 2, I'm pretty sure they mentioned that Superman just put Lex Luthor away before that season started. We didn't get to see Superman in this episode, and we won't at all this season. We probably will next season in Crisis on Infinite Earths and possibly in a spinoff show that might not happen. It probably won't happen. I don't know. But this flashback was actually pretty great. We saw the real Lex Luthor that we didn't again see in this episode until the end. But this was definitely a great way to start the episode and a great debut and great introduction to Lex Luthor. And in those flashbacks, we got to hear his motivation, which is pretty comic book accurate. In this episode, we hear that he thinks that the humanity depends on Superman too much, and that's basically his motivation in the comics. Superman's basically like a weakness for humanity, and he thinks that he has to get rid of Superman because of that. But also on top of that, it's kind of selfish in the fact that he thinks he should be the hero of Metropolis and not Superman. So I do think that they nailed that part of Lex Luthor as well. His motivation and everything, the reason he's doing everything and the reason he hates Superman, that was pretty clear in this episode, and this is just a great introduction and debut for the character. In the rest of the episode, until the end, Lex Luthor was definitely not as interesting, and if Lex Luthor was as good as he was in the beginning and the end, this episode would have been a great, great episode, probably the best episode of the season, and it might still be, but I think that because he was sick the entirety of the episode, it's not as good, and I don't think he was as interesting because he was a lot more dependent on, like, Lena, for instance, and it wasn't until the end with the twist that we learned that he kind of wasn't, but in the actual scenes, it just wasn't as interesting or gripping. This isn't a complaint, really, at all, because I love how they set up this twist at the end where it turns out that Lex Luthor was behind the entirety of this episode, and I will talk about that later in this review, but even though I like how they handled that, it was still less interesting when he was sick and he wasn't as genius and wasn't as really badass, but in his own way, in those scenes. Still, though, I do think that he was pretty good, and I liked his conversations with Lena quite a lot. I liked their back and forth because they obviously had a history together. They are half-siblings and they grew up together, so I do think that was pretty good. Again, it wasn't amazing or anything, but it definitely was pretty good. I'll talk about the rest of Lex Luthor at the end because that is at the end of the episode, but there are a lot of other things in this episode that are nowhere near as interesting or gripping as Lex Luthor as a character himself, and I feel like that's how the season will go at the end, or like from now on. It will be whenever Lex Luthor is on screen, it's gonna be good. Whenever he's not, it probably won't be. Very similar to when Superman is appearing on the show, because for some reason, the show handles Superman characters pretty well, like Superman himself, Lois Lane, and Lex Luthor. Not so much Jimmy Olsen, because they completely changed everything about him, but I'm sure if they kept it comic accurate, he would have been great as well. It's very crazy. It's crazy how well they do certain Superman characters, that when they're on screen, it makes the show so much better, like Superman and, right now, Lex Luthor. But speaking of James Olsen, this episode was very centered around the fact that he was shot in the last episode, which I definitely thought would set up a gun control episode. As it was said, there would be another one of those this season. It turns out it actually didn't, and I'm very glad that it didn't, because that would have sucked. In the end, it was revealed that Lex Luthor was behind the shooting, which was a great twist that I did not see coming. But again, since that was at the end of the episode, I will talk about that at the end of this review. This actual storyline with James was definitely not the strong point of the episode. In fact, it was the exact opposite. There was the everything with Lex Luthor. There was the storyline with Manchester Black and Martian Manhunter, which are both way, way better. Everything, every single time they went back to this hospital, it was not anywhere near as interesting as the rest of the episode. And again, I don't actually care if James died either. It wasn't exactly suspenseful, because it's a pretty terrible character, and every time that I get the opportunity to mention how comic book inaccurate he is, then I will, and I don't really care if he dies. So this storyline was definitely not suspenseful, and all the scenes scenes and storylines in this storyline, the fact that James is shot and is getting this surgery. There was the scenes with Brainy and Nia, which were very, very weird. The scenes with Alex and Kelly, Kelly's a new character, didn't exactly make a very big impact as a character. And the fact that it was announced that she will be a series regular next season is not exactly something I'm excited about. I don't care about this character either. In general, the storyline was easily the weakest part of the episode, which is weird because it's kind of the driving force of the episode. It's all happening because Lex Luthor returned and set up the shooting that shot James Olsen, and also the fact that James was shot set up Martian Manhunter thinking that it was Manchester Black and going after Manchester Black, unless Black was actually hired by Lex Luthor. We will probably find out if that's true. It probably isn't because they have conflicting ideologies. But anyway, James being shot was the catalyst to everything that happened in the episode, and yet it was the least interesting part of this episode. All the scenes in the hospital, all the scenes between the characters in the hospital, except for at the end when Lena was using the Haridol on James, everything outside of that was very, very boring, and the fact that James was dying was not exactly suspenseful at all. But there's also the storyline with Manchester Black and Martian Manhunter, which was pretty good. I think that Manchester Black getting his more comic book accurate powers, like he now has this telepathic link to Martian Manhunter, and he uses this Martian staff from the god, or one of the gods from Mars, that gives him very similar powers to how he has in the comics, and I definitely liked that quite a lot. I really liked his rivalry with Martian Manhunter throughout all these episodes, and the conflict he causes in Jon, although it is a little bit contrived and it comes out of nowhere a lot of the times, it is still pretty good nonetheless. I hate the fact that Jon is never in his Martian form, but there was a moment at the end where he turned into his Martian form, and it was pretty awesome. I mean, any moment where he turns into his Martian form, it's automatically so much cooler than when he isn't. I will say it right now, every single scene he uses his powers when he's not in his Martian form, it's ridiculous, and I really, really hate it. But when he is in his Martian form, and he has the CGI around him that looks like CGI, but at the same time, I'm glad that it does, because it does make him look like a Martian, and it does like make him look very different from how he does in his human form. It's just so much more awesome, and it is genuinely awesome, and I loved Martian Manhunter before he stopped turning into his Martian form, because he kind of did it a lot in season 1 and 2, kind of, but then in season 3 and especially 4, I hate the fact that he doesn't do that. But in general, this storyline is definitely not a bad one, although it definitely is not the best part of the episode. That would be the beginning of the episode, where the flashback to 4 years ago, and the best part of the episode is easily the end, with everything to do with Lex Luthor. At the end, Lena confronts Lex Luthor about the cure and saying that she actually ended up using it and it worked on James, and she's not going to use it on Lex because he orchestrated the death of, or the shooting of, James Olsen. I like that twist quite a lot, the fact that Lex Luthor was behind the shooting, because again, I suspected that the shooting would incur a gun control episode, because it's just a random guy who uses a gun and is able to get a gun. Turns out he was financed by a billionaire, so it's definitely not setting up that gun control episode. On top of that, it makes so much sense because of what Lex said earlier in the episode, which is that he needed to push Lena into completing things, which he did in this episode as well. He pushed Lena into finishing the Haranol in order to save James, which she ended up doing, which also cured Lex. In the moment in the episode, I thought that it was a pretty stupid moment, pretty stupid on Lex's part, when he admitted that he was behind the shooting of James before Lena gave him the cure, because obviously, why would she give him the cure after he admitted that? So I thought that was a stupid moment at the moment, and I thought Lex was pretty stupid for doing that, but it was revealed that he already took the cure, and that was a pretty great twist that I did not see coming, and it was a pretty great moment as well for the character. On top of that, probably the biggest twist of the episode, the biggest twist of the show ever, really like the most character development or most character changes any character has ever gone through on the show, except for maybe Mon-El, who went from how he was in season 2 to how he was in season 3, but Eve Tessmacher, who I'm pretty sure was the assistant to Cat Grant from all the way back in the first episode of the show, or at least season 1, was revealed to be working with Lex Luthor this entire time, and that was a pretty insane twist. And obviously, we probably probably should have seen this coming because the name Testmacher is a reference to the assistant to Lex Luthor back in the Superman movies from the 70s, which are not movies I've ever seen, but I am aware of that character. So this is a twist that I think was pretty awesome. I didn't see coming, and it makes so much sense because of the reference to that character. He even made a reference, Lex Luthor screamed Testmacher like he did in those movies. Again, I didn't see the movies, but I'm aware of that and everything that happened like that, so I think that was pretty awesome. However, there was one downside to all this. It was revealed that Otis Graves is still alive, and that sucks because Otis Graves is probably one of, if not the worst character on the show ever, the worst character in the Arrowverse. He is terrible. The actor is horrible. I hate how he acts. I hate everything about him, and I was so happy when he died. His death felt a little premature, though, and so did Mercy's death. I can't remember if she died or not, but either way, it seems like those characters left pretty early on. Even though I really wanted them to, it felt like it was too good to be true, and it kind of was. It seems like they're both coming back now and working with Lex Luthor, which does make sense because they both do work with or for Lex Luthor in the comics, and they're known to be the bodyguards of Lex Luthor, at least Mercy Graves is. But I don't like this one thing because I hated Otis, and I'm so not glad that he is back. That's the one thing I hated about this big twist. It's like a huge amount of twists at the end of this episode. But at the end, Lex Luthor leaves the Lex, or the mansion, the Luthor mansion, and cloaks it in a cloaking device, gets on his helicopter, and we see the Supergirl and Lex come face to face for the first time ever. And I am pretty excited for the next episode as well, because Lex Luthor was an incredible villain at the end and at the beginning of this episode, and I'm genuinely excited to see more of him. And there's really not much else in this season that I'm excited to see more of, but Lex Luthor is definitely a character that I think can be an incredible main villain of a Superman TV show, but even a Supergirl TV show. That is definitely something that can and probably will work based off this episode. I think John Cryer also did an incredible job in the role. The only downside, the only thing that I don't like about the character is the fact that he has a beard. I think it looks a little bit weird, and I'm sure he's probably going to shave it anytime soon because that's not how he looks in the comics, and that's the one thing that I think is not great about the character. It just looks a little bit unusual. But aside from that, I think the actor is great. I think the way they're using the character with the twists and turns, it turns out he's basically behind everything in this season. This season might end up being a lot better than I first thought it would be, and it's all because of one character, Lex Luthor. In conclusion, I think this episode is a huge step up for the season as well as the show. The introduction of Lex Luthor as the villain, or a villain, is so good, and John Cryer just does such a great job in the role. He makes the episode so much better than it would have been, because the storyline with James, not exactly good, and all the scenes in the hospital are pretty average to even mediocre slash bad. And although the storyline with Martian Manhunter and Manchester Black is pretty good, it's nowhere near as good as everything to do with Lex Luthor in the portrayal of the character, as well as the reveals and twists connected to the villain. So I will give this episode a very high for this show, 9 out of 10, because of Lex Luthor. Let me know in the comments down below what you think about the character of Lex Luthor as well as this episode. And if you like this video, make sure to leave a like, share, and subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching.